Hi friends, my name is Sirkam Shah and I am from class 9th. Today we are going to speak about Pythagoras theorem. First we will see that who discovered the Pythagoras theorem and when it was discovered. The Pythagoras theorem was discovered 2000 years ago by a philosopher known as Pythagoras. Now we will see that what did he discover. He discovered that when a triangle has right angle that is 90 degree and squares are made on each of the three sides, then the other two squares are put together to make the exact same area of the biggest square. This is called as Pythagoras theorem. Means you can see here, this is a right angle triangle which is having 90 degree, and this is 3, means this side's length is 3, this 4 and this is 5. This is known as hypotenuse side in 90 degree triangle. And these boxes, there are 3 boxes on each of the sides. This is of 3 into 3, this is 4 into 4 and this is 5 into 5. Now when we add this both the squares, and then we should get the area of this square. Means when we add 3 into 3 equals to 9 and 4 into 4 equals to 16, when we add 16 and 9, we have to get 25. Now if we add 16 plus 9 equals to 25, and this is also equals to 25, so 25 equals to 25. So this is known as Pythagoras theorem. Now we'll see what the means, which kind of formula is used to solve the problem of right angle triangle in which we can find one side. The formula is a square plus b square equals to c square. Now we'll see that what is proper definition for Pythagoras theorem. In a right angle triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Means here you can see here that this both the squares, when we add this both the squares, it is equal to this square. Now we'll see that why is Pythagoras theorem used. Now if we know the two sides of the triangle and we don't know the third side of the triangle, then we can use the Pythagoras theorem. But this Pythagoras theorem is only used in right angle triangle. Now we'll see some examples. Example 1. Find the length of AC in the below triangle. In this triangle, we have to find the length of the AC. To find this, we will use the Pythagoras theorem. First, we will note down what things they have given. So, given AB equals to 5 cm, BC equals to 12 cm, and AC they have not given. So, AC equals to question mark. Now, the formula we will use. Formula is AB square plus BC square equals to AC square. Now we'll put the values. AB equals to 5 square and BC equals to 12 and square equals to AC square. Now 5 square equals to 25 plus 12 square equals to 144 equals to AC square. Now when we add this both, we will get 169 equals to AC square. Now next, here there is the square. So we have to take this square, we have to shift this square this side. So it will become root 169 equals to AC. The root of 169 is 13. AC. So the length of this AC is equal to 13. Therefore we found the AC length equals to 13 centimeter. We used Pythagoras theorem in this sum and we found the length of the AC. Now we'll see the next example. In this triangle we have to find whether it is a right triangle triangle. To find this right angle triangle, we can find it by Pythagoras theorem, because if we add this both squares, then it should be equals to this side square. So we can find it by Pythagoras theorem. So first we will note down the values. D1 equals to AB equals to 3, BC equals to 4 centimeter, and AC equals to 5 centimeter. So now we'll apply the formula equals to AB square plus BC square plus AC square, sorry, equals to AC square. Now we'll put the values. 3 square, BC equals to 4 square, and AC equals to 5 square. Now we'll do 3 square equals to 9, sorry, here plus 3, 3 is a 9, so 9, and 4 square equals to 16, 4 4 is a 16, and 5 2 is a means 5 square, 5 5 is a 25. Now when we add the 16 and 9, 25 equals to 25. Now this 25 is equal to 25, means this both when we add we means this both the squares when we add we get 25, and this 5 square is 25, so this both the means when we add this we get 25, so it is right angle triangle. Therefore it is right angled triangle. Now we'll see that how we can prove the Pythagoras theorem. To prove this Pythagoras theorem, I have made one model for you. You can see here that here there is a triangle and there are three squares. When we add this both the squares into this, then this full square will be filled with the these particles. So when I fill this both the particles in this, this full will be filled. You can see it is filling. To fill this, I am making it cross little bit. You can also make, and you can also try it at your home. To make it, it is very easy. Here. Here, now this full is filled. With this we can prove that Pythagoras theorem. When we add this both we get the this area, means when we add both the this both area we have to get this box's area, like this only. In this also we have it. When we'll add this we have to get this number. Thank you friends for watching.